Okay, Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So this video will cover the final part of chapter 4 bipolar transistor biasing circuits. So what is bipolar transistor biasing? So basically biasing refers to the DC voltages applied to the transistor for it to turn on and operate in the forward active region. Okay, so your BJT has to operate in the active region so that it can properly function as an amplifier to amplify your input signal. Alright, so a proper biasing effect will make sure that if this is your input signal, okay, so when it is properly biased in the active region, so all your input signal here will be amplified and you will get the output signal. However, if you did not do a proper biasing, you can see here some of the input signal is biased in this region. So this region is your saturation region. That's why you only obtain half of the output signal because only this portion is being biased at the active region. Okay, so that's the purpose of the biasing circuit. There are three types of biasing configurations. The first one is the fixed bias biasing circuit. The second one is this biasing using collector to base. And the final one is the voltage divider biasing circuit. So the first type of biasing circuit is the fixed bias biasing circuit. So when you look at the term fixed, it means that you provide the same power supply to the BE loop and also the CE loop. So in the previous examples, you can see that for the BE loop, it has a different power supply over here, and then the CE loop is connected to the VCC, right? Okay, so in this case, both are connected to the same fixed power supply. So that's the meaning of the fixed bias biasing circuit, okay? So there are two ways for you to solve this kind of circuit. So I'm going to show you both methods. So the first one is the node voltages. And then when you know the node voltages, you can do the branch current equations. I think I have shown you a few times on the branch current equations, especially when you do the nodal analysis, right? So let me show you, okay? So the first one, because your emitter is directly connected to ground, so it means that this node is 0 volt, okay? And then we are given VBE on equivalent to 0.7 volt. Therefore, can you find your VB? Yes, because VB minus VE is given as 0.7, okay? So this is the equation. So you can calculate what is VB. So you want to find what is IB. So IB is this branch, right? It's connected between node 12 volt and VB, right? So that's why, because of the current direction, IB is equivalent to 12 minus VB, and VB is 0.7 over RB 240 kilo ohm, and you get the base current. After that, you can calculate IC using IC equivalent to beta IB, and you get this answer. Similarly, you can find VCE using the branch current equation by using this branch. Alright, so what do you think the equation will be? So for IC, it will be VCC minus VC, right? So VCC minus VC over the resistor RC equivalent to IC, right? So you can see here 12 minus VC over the resistor 2.2 kilo ohm equivalent to the collector current. And you have calculated IC, okay? And you managed to find what is your node voltage. Node voltage at the collector terminal, right? The question asks for VCE means that VCE equivalent to VC minus VE, and hence you get the answer 6.819 volt for your VCE. So this is another approach when you know node voltages. Of course, I'm going to show you the traditional way, which is the loop. So just imagine that I pull this over here for you to have the power supply, okay? Alright, and this is 12 volt, okay? So if you do your KBL here, which is your BE loop, right? So what will you get? You will have IBRB plus VBE, don't forget your VBE over here, minus 12 volt, right? So this is what I get. And directly you can get what is IB, and straight away use the formula to get your IC, okay? So for my CE loop, similarly, if I bring the power supply to my right hand side here, alright? Okay, so I can see my CE loop, and I do my loop like this. So the equation will be ICRC plus VCE minus VCC. Okay, and this is what I obtained. And you can calculate your VCE straight away. And the answer is still the same as the previous slide. So this is just some options for you. So that's for fixed bias biasing circuit. Next is the biasing using collector to base feedback resistor. So for this biasing circuit, similarly, it is easier if you use the node voltages and the branch current equation. So for example, in this circuit, you are given the current IE and VCE, okay? And you are asked to find RB and RC. Okay, so the first thing you can see straight away is your emitter terminal here is directly connected to ground, just like the fixed bias biasing circuit example just now. So VE is equivalent to 0 volt because it is directly connected to ground, right? So let's see. VE equivalent to 0, okay? Because you are already given one current and you are given beta. Definitely you can find the other currents. You can find IB using IE over beta plus 1 and you obtain 0.0099 milliampere. Okay, and IB is the current flowing through this branch, which means that the equation for IB is VC minus VB over RB. Okay, so you need to find what is VC, VB, and then you can calculate to find what is RB, right? Okay, so this is where node voltages will come into play. But VC is equivalent to VCE. That's what I stated here. But how did I come to this conclusion? It's because VCE is equivalent to VC minus VE, the potential difference between two nodes. But we know VE is 0. So that's how VCE is equivalent to VC. And we are given VCE as 2.3. So VC will be equivalent to 2.3 volt. Okay. Next is VB, right? And I wrote there VB equivalent to VBE, equivalent to 0.7. Same thing, because VBE equivalent to VB minus VE and VE is 0. So VB is equivalent to 0.7. So you put in the values over here and then you can proceed to calculate what is your RB. The answer is 161.6 kilo ohm. Okay. Next, you need to find what is RC, right? So what is the current flowing through your RC? Now, student might make a careless mistake where they will think that the current flowing through RC is the collector current. However, because of the nature of this feedback resistor, IC will only flow from this point onwards. Okay, actually the current flowing through this branch is IE because the current goes here and split IB and IC, which means that this is IE. So please take note that because of this feedback loop, the current here is IE. Okay, so the branch current equation will be VCC minus VC over RC equivalent to the current IE. Okay, so this is the branch current equation. VCC, we know it's 10 volt. VC is 2.3 volt. And you can proceed to calculate your RC. Okay, so you can see it is easier to calculate using node voltages, right? But if you still feel that you want to do the BE loop, of course you can try using this loop. Okay, so the loop for BE loop will be this way. Okay, alright, that's one. And so for CE loop, you can use KVL at this loop. So please try to do the KVL using the BE loop and CE loop and see whether you can get the same answers. So the next technique is the voltage divider biasing circuit. So this is your voltage divider biasing circuit. Don't worry about this portion of your circuit because this is related to AC signal. So for this chapter, we are only going to consider the DC analysis. So you can see here, we have these two resistors here, R1 and R2 connected to the power supply. So what you want to do is you want to convert this portion of your circuit, okay, into a Thevenin equivalent. So in order to do that, let's imagine that you take away this portion here and what you are left with is this. So this is the portion where you have the R1 and R2. So you want to create a Thevenin equivalent seen from this terminal. So firstly, for Thevenin, in order to find the Thevenin resistance, you need to turn off the power supply. So when you do that, and when you want to calculate RTH, you can see that R1 and R2 is in parallel. So RTH is equivalent to R1 and R2 in parallel, which is this equation. Okay? So next is to find the Thevenin voltage. So you can see here in this circuit, VTH is the voltage across R2, which means that you can use voltage divider. Okay? So VTH is calculated using voltage divider, R2 over R1 plus R2 multiplied with the power supply. Okay, so this is where you get the term voltage divider, because you need to calculate VTH using the voltage divider equation. Okay, so once you do all this, you will get a circuit that is simplified as follows. You can see here VTH and RTH, and this is the other portion of your BJT circuit. So you can see the BJT circuit that I have covered in your DC analysis. So you can do your BE loop and CE loop easily. Okay, so let's do one example. Okay, so in this example, you are given this voltage divider circuit and you are asked to find the three currents and the voltage VCE. Okay, so you are given all the parameters and beta is 100. Okay, so the first thing you need to do when you are given a voltage divider configuration is to calculate VTH, right? So VTH is the voltage divider where R2 over R1 plus R2 multiply with the voltage supply, and you get the answer 1.79 volt. Secondly is the calculation of Thevenin resistance, where R1 is in parallel with R2. So for two resistors in parallel, you can use this equation and you will get the answer as 10 kilo ohm. Alright, so once you've done your Thevenin equivalent, you can get this equivalent circuit. So as you bring VCC to the common ground here, okay, so you will be able to see the CE loop. Okay, so the first loop is the BE loop, right? You can see that I have converted IE into base current, where IE is equivalent to 1 plus beta IB. And so I managed to get what is the base current. After that, you can compute the collector current and the emitter current. Okay, so next is the CE loop, which is straightforward. So ICRC plus VCE plus IERE minus VCC, and you can obtain the voltage VCE equivalent to 4.8 volt. Okay, so next example is a design question where you are given the circuit and some extra info, where you are given the emitter current and the RTH. So you are asked to find what is R1 and R2. So I have informed you before, even though it's a design question, the approach is always the same. Just do your BE loop and CE loop as usual, and you can automatically see how to get the answer. Okay? You can see here, we start with the BE loop, IBRTH plus VBE plus IERE minus VTH. And because RTH is given, okay, and your IB can be calculated because you are given what is the emitter current, and you are also given beta, and you can find VTH. So now you have the VTH equation and RTH equation, two equations with two unknown, and you can solve R1 and R2. Okay, so I just want to show you a bit of trick here. In your RTH equation, you can see this term, the highlighted term here, and the term is also available here in your VTH equation. So that's how I managed to shorten the time to calculate one of the resistor. And then after that, you can use one of the equation to calculate R2. Okay? So that's an example of a design question. So this is another voltage divider question. It's a design question as well, and I'm going to show this on the whiteboard. Okay?
A few moments later.
So brothers and sisters, this is the circuit in the example, which is a standard voltage divider circuit. You are given these parameters: VCC 16 volt, VCE 8 volt. The collector current IC is 2 milliampere, beta is 200, RE is 1 kilo ohm, and you are given R1 2.5 kilo ohm. So the question asks you to design this circuit, which means that you need to find the unknown resistors, and the unknown resistors are RC and R2. Okay? Since the question did not give what is VBE, so we just assume VBE is 0.7 volt. Okay? So of course you're going to do the same approach, which is the BE loop and CE loop, in order to solve this. But because you are given the current IC, let's just calculate the values of the other currents. So IC is equivalent to beta IB. Therefore, IB is equivalent to 2 over 200, which is 0.01
milliampere. So that is your base current. Next, we know that IC is equivalent to alpha IE, and alpha is equivalent to beta over beta plus 1. Therefore, combining these two formulas, we can calculate IE, which is 2 multiplied with 201 over 200, and you will get 2.01 milliampere. Okay, so now you know these two currents, alright? So I'm going to wipe this circuit off. So VTH is equivalent to R1 plus R2 multiplied with the 16 volt, which is the value of the power supply, and RTH is equivalent to R1 plus R2. Okay, so based on the previous example, you can see this term in here. Okay, so I can simplify RTH to be R1, okay, multiply with VTH over 16, right? So I'm going to make use of this later when we are dealing with the BE loop and CE loop. Okay, so now I'm going to wipe this off. So once you do your VTH and RTH, your circuit is now simplified to be, this is your RC, RE and ground, and you bring your VCC to the common ground. So this is 16 volt, this is RC, this is RE, and you have your RTH here and your VTH. Okay, so this is my VTH, right, and my VCE is here, and this is my VBE, alright, and these are my current directions, right? Okay, so now if you do your BE loop first, okay, if I want to do my KVL, so I start with the IBRTH, so IBRTH plus VBE plus IERE, okay, minus VTH equivalent to 0, alright, my CE loop is equivalent to ICRC plus VCE plus IERE minus 16 volt equivalent to 0. So this is my BE loop equation and CE loop equation. Okay, so we know this value, which is 0.7, and we also know this value as well, IERE. Okay, and we have calculated IB. Alright, so that's what we know in BE loop. As for CE loop, again, we know IC. We are given what is VCE, and this is also the same term here. We are given these values, and that's it, right? So you can see here, in your CE loop, the only unknown is your RC. So you can solve CE loop first in order to calculate RC. So I'm going to do that this side. So I'm going to deal with the CE loop first in order to calculate your RC. So what I have is 2 times RC plus 8 plus 2.01 multiplied with 1 minus 16 volt equivalent to 0. So RC is equivalent to 8 minus 2.01 over 2. So the value of RC is approximately 3 kilo ohm. Okay, so you have solved for RC. Okay, but for BE loop, it's a bit tricky because you have two unknowns here. You have RTH and VTH. However, we have already established the representation of RTH in terms of VTH just now. So we can calculate the value of VTH. So I'm going to wipe this portion off. So let me write back the equation for BE loop here. IB RTH plus VBE plus IERE minus VTH equivalent to 0. Okay, so IB is 0.01, RTH plus 0.7 plus 2.01 multiplied with 1 minus VTH equivalent to 0. Next, 0.01 RTH plus 2.71 minus VTH equivalent to 0. Right? But RTH is equivalent to R1 VTH over 16. And R1 is given to you, so 2.5 VTH over 16. So you can replace this inside here, and you will have an equation with only one unknown. And once I do that, so VTH equivalent to 2.714 volt. Okay, so that's equation for VTH. but it's not finished yet, right? Because you still need to calculate what is R2. Okay, so I'm going to wipe this off. So VTH is equivalent to R2, R1 plus R2 multiplied with the power supply 16. So we know VTH is 2.714 equivalent to R2, 2.5 plus R2 multiplied with the power supply 16. So you can solve this equation and eventually you will get R2 equivalent to 0.5 kilo ohm. Okay, so that's the value of R2. So that's it. You have solved this example. It's a bit long, but you just stick to the basic and inshallah you will be fine. So I'll see you in the next video for chapter 5. Assalamualaikum. Bye.